you seem to treat it as if people off the telly drop by every Sunday morning.
Should have practiced this bit.
Hello, you're Teresa.
I am Teresa.
Hello.
Hello.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Noel Eggmans.
I know you're Noel Eggmans. I'm just cooking an egg for my friend, so it's quite...
Well, I know you're mad on chickens.
I am very mad on chickens.
But where do they live?
They live in my back garden.
Can I see them?
Yes, of course you can.
Oh, sorry, I put a bit of weight on. Teresa, you're being very calm about this. Do you have any idea why I am standing in your back garden dressed as an egg?
I have absolutely no idea whatsoever.
I'm aware that you have shown extraordinary support for your mum and dad.
Yeah.
So much so that you've even given up on a holiday. I heard about the chickens. And I heard, if you don't mind me saying, that they're not in the most luxurious residence they could. Would that be fair to say?
That would be fair to say. We made it.
Right. Do we have your permission to now, courtesy of my friends at Argus, build a hen palace?
That would be fantastic.
Okay. That's what we're going to do for you.
Thank
because you,
you
are just the most perfect daughter.
Oh, thank you. You want to cuddle a chicken?
It occurs to me this chicken could be traumatised by the sight of such a large egg.
Such a large egg.
She'll do anything for anybody if she can, you know, she'll all do somebody a good turn and do somebody a bad turn. If anybody, you know, requires something, she will go out of way to do it for somebody.
The big moment, come around here, come on.
Are you... Oh my word!
Absolutely marvellous!
Are we talking about lucky chickens or what?
My word, I think we could rehome everybody in there. It's great.
Isn't that good?
That is absolutely amazing. That is huge.
It's fantastic, isn't it? Now, there's a little bit more to you than meets the eye, really. Not only do I know that you are a fantastic daughter, but of course, you've got another fresh challenge in your life because of Ian's illness.
Yeah.
How much do you want to talk about it?
Basically, I have two brain tumours, which is malignant. excuse me. So it's basically brain cancer. It's terminal.
Yeah. Doing amazing.
Yeah, of course.
So, considering what he's got.
Every day is a new day.
What is the prognosis in?
With the chemotherapy, the best that they're saying that we can hope for is months rather than years.
Really?
So I'm going to say it's a bit of a toughie.
Yeah.
Well then, this has an extra poignancy. I know that you wanted to go on the holiday of a lifetime. You wanted to be together for one more romantic holiday, but there's been a problem with insurance.
Yes.
Right. I've cut through the red tape on the insurance, which is why we've organised for you a Mediterranean cruise to go to Sicily, Italy, Malta, around the Mediterranean, as soon as we can possibly go, and you will have one fabulous romantic holiday.
Wow, thank you so much.
Thank you.
The least we can do, Ian, the least we can do.
That's really lovely.
Good luck to you both.
Thank
and
you.
I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful time on the holiday.
Oh, wow.
Thank you. Thank you.
Merry Christmas to you.
Thank you.
Oh, wow, look at the size of that.
God, it's absolutely huge.
Buongiorno.
Oh, wow.
That's huge.
You're not kidding.
We've got a party, have you?
Isn't it lovely? Oh, that is
Welcome on board the Costa Concordia. As you know, my gift for both of you is to have the most luxurious and romantic cruise possible. To do this, I've arranged for you to be extra special guests on board the ship. I know your time is very precious together, so I want everything to be perfect. Please enjoy your first class suite with private balcony, your very own butler, and an invitation to dine with the exclusive Michelin star restaurant on me.
Wow. Fantastic.
Have a wonderful cruise. You're two truly wonderful people who deserve this. Merry Christmas, Noel.
Thank you, Noel.
Thank you. That was fab.
Butler service.
Hello.
Cheers. Happy cruising.
Yeah, here's to a good cruise.
This cruise has been very important because it just gives us time together. It would be so easy just to say I can't handle it anymore. But you have to. You have to just get on with everyday existence. So everything you do every day, you just don't take for granted anymore. You just enjoy whatever you do. People say, I hope to find my soulmate. I did. And, you know, just to be together, it's wonderful.
We're very, very lucky because there's not a lot of people that do find that. To it makes you very sad that it's going to be taken away.
Yeah.
That's a real sad part. But we're creating all the special memories now. That's what we're doing.
Exactly. Yeah. I'm taking memories with me. Yeah, okay. I'll be a very lucky man. Oh, yes. As long as I'm with you, always.
Thank you so much for your honesty, which I'm sure will be an inspiration to many people this Christmas, Ian. Really hope those doctors are wrong.
It would be nice.
Yes. Hope you've got a lot of time together. The chickens, I believe, are doing extremely well.
Oh, they're absolutely loving their new palace. So
I heard a rather disturbing rumour that you're intending to buy more chickens next year, and one of them will be called...
Noella.
Yes.
Yes, it's got to be.
You can see why I was so disturbed by that. It's been a real pleasure to meet you. You are extraordinary, and I hope you enjoyed our Christmas gifts. I wish you a very happy Christmas.
Thank you.
Welcome back. I think you are really going to enjoy this Christmas present. I'm going to introduce you to a family who really do believe in that old adage, family first. They are the Browns. And Andy and Liz have four children. Their son Robert has cerebral palsy. And last Christmas, Robert needed a vital operation. What that meant to the family was that they couldn't have Christmas at home, which is why I was determined that Christmas 2008 would be memorable for the Browns for all the right reasons. And then I heard that Liz was having a surprise birthday party. So I thought, right, let's take a cake to Wakefield.
The spirit of Christmas past.
I know. Last Christmas, you didn't really have a Christmas. You had to cancel it, didn't you? But this Christmas, 2008, I am going to give you guys a Christmas you will remember for the rest of your lives.